Hi! In this video, we are going to take a look at customizing the iSpring Universal Player. Here, I am in the preview mode for my presentation. It looks nice, but with iSpring Suite, we can customize everything you want in this player, from the top and bottom bars, to the buttons, and of course, the player layout and the color scheme. Let's close this preview and take a look at how to make some of these changes. I want to start by looking at the different player options that there are available. First, I will select the Player button on the iSpring Suite tab. Once the player options are open, I can go to the Select Player button and choose from three templates. Universal, which is a highly customizable HTML5 player with advanced features. Video Lecture, which will help focus your user's attention either on the course material or on the lecturer whenever it is necessary. And None or Slide Only, when only the course slides are displayed. Customization is similar with all three players, although every player has its own specific settings. I'm going to stick with the Universal for now. Now, if I move over here to the Templates section, you can see that there are a ton of pre-built templates you can choose from. I want to customize my player layout, so I'm going to keep moving on to the Layout button. Here you have all of your controls. I can adjust my player panels by checking or unchecking the top bar, bottom bar, and sidebar boxes, as well as adjusting positions. I can also configure my player features by selecting if and how the different elements in my presentation will appear. I don't need notes to appear in the sidebar, so I'm going to change this option to none. The same goes for presenter video. You can see that they have both been removed from the sidebar. I'm going to leave the rest of these options as is for now. I can also customize each bar individually. Let's take a look at the top bar. Here, I can choose whether or not my course title appears in the top bar, as well as adding buttons. See here, Marker Tools is checked, so it shows up in the top bar of my slide. You have a whole set of customizations for each bar. Okay, now I am ready to look at my playback and navigation options. Here I can set up the playback of the course when reopened by changing the On Restart drop-down menu. I like the Prompt to Resume option because it gives my students the choice to resume the course from where they left off or to start it over. Here I can select my navigation options. I want my course to be viewed forward only. Then, under Navigation, you can choose to navigate by slides, which means you move from one slide to another, or animation, if your PowerPoint contains animations and you want it to move between animations. To enable keyboard navigation, make sure this box is checked. This will allow your students to use their keyboard to navigate through the slides, adjust the volume on videos, fast forward and rewind when applicable, and more. I like to have this option selected to make things easier for my students. To adjust which keys will do what, you can customize the control keys here. Down at the bottom, you have two final options: to start presentation automatically and save slide animated state, which means animated slides will remain in their state when a user visits the slide again. This option works for trigger animations and bullets that appear on mouse click. I am going to select color from the top menu. From here, I am able to choose a color scheme. There are a lot of light and dark options. I'm going to go with the light red scheme. From here, I could move on, or I could work to customize my colors even further. You can adjust the colors of your page and player background, text, buttons, the sidebar, and pop-ups. You have total control. The red isn't quite right. I'm going to change it by selecting it and using the eyedropper to choose the red I actually want. Now I will select OK. That looks much better. I'm going to make a few more quick adjustments. There, now all my reds are correct. Finally, let's take a look at text labels. Here is where you can change the language of the player. I'm sticking with English. You can adjust any of the text that appears on the Universal Player or in the pop-up windows. Let's see what happens when I change the sidebar outline text to Overview. See? It now says Overview in the sidebar, and our language has changed to a custom preset. If you want to save your changes as a preset, you can do that by selecting the Save icon beside it. Okay, now we are ready to apply and close. And there it is, my customized player. I think it looks pretty great.